1993. Everyone has a start to their life. 1993 was mine. It was during this year that my mom and dad were trying to decide the proper place to live. They had narrowed it down to two towns, Tonkawa and another one nearby. There are a few reasons as to why they picked Tonkawa over the other, but one event happened here in Tonkawa that was the pushing factor of the decision where my family was to live. As this story was told to me, my mother was picking up a few items from the grocery store here in town. While she was checking out, the lady behind my mother was talking to the cashier and telling her something to the effect of, "I saw your son out there where he wasn't supposed to be. I told him I'd tell you he was out there, and that he told me that you wouldn't be surprised if I did." And at that, my mom decided this is where she wanted to live. She wanted to live here because of the sense of community and trust here in this town. She wanted to live here because here we look out for each other. I wouldn't be who I am today if it were not for this town. For this act, I owe my deepest gratitude for those ladies. I owe my deepest gratitude to everyone who makes this town feel like home. Adults, students, teachers. Thank you for helping me and my peers become who we are. Seniors, we have worked hard for this moment. 12 years we have worked for this. Together, we have gained new experiences, endured harsh losses, and grew to become mature adults. Well, mature-ish. However, this is the time to build upon what we have learned and show the world who we are. Now is the time to make the difference in the world. I look at all of you and see nothing but bright futures. There is not one of you here that is not bound for success. But I need you to have perseverance to get there. Hard work for your future is what is needed. Never let it go, because no one will get your future for you. However, like many other journeys, there is more than just the basics to pack if you want to be prepared. Perseverance is needed most, but stress management and support are also very important. Remember to take a breath. Breaks are needed on a long walk. And support? I always like to think Tonkawa as a hand extended to pull you up when you're down. This brings me to another story my dad has told me. When my parents were driving through Tonkawa for the first time, they passed another car. But this car was different than any car they had passed before. In this car, the driver waved. Have you ever noticed here that people in Tonkawa wave at one another? Although a simple act, through this gesture, we show how we are. Friendly, caring, willing. Here in this town, we wave. However, once you leave the city limits, people stop waving. Out there, no one is out here to watch your kids when they're out when they aren't supposed to be. Out there, you don't know who everyone is and who can be trusted. Out there, you don't know if someone will pull over to help you if your car is broken down. Out there, people stop waving. That is what makes this town so great. We look out for one another, despite that we have different views, despite that sometimes there are feuds, despite that we may not talk much to each other. If it came down for it, we would look out for one another. We would take care of one another, and yes, we would wave to one another. This, seniors, I challenge you. Wave. Wave to everyone around you and smile. We have been surrounded by support and help. Let us take up the torch and bring our caring to the world and wave on. Thank you.